Earth to Zell.
Hey.
Here you go. One Trenta, five shot, half calf, no foam, pumpkin spice latte, no foam, at exactly 210 degrees.
What?
Never mind, it's just a regular coffee.
Thanks.
What's wrong? I thought my Scream Queen references always made you laugh.
I'm just a little shaken up over the whole thing still. God, why did she have to go outside? If she just stayed in the apartment, she'd probably still be alive right now.
At least it wasn't me. I was so close to opening that door. What? I'm just saying.
Look, I know it's hard, but if we all stick together and finally catch Emma, then all this can finally be over.
It's easier said than done. I mean, every episode we talk about how we're gonna find Emma, we're gonna catch her, everything's gonna be over. But we haven't actually done anything about it.
Yeah, you're kind of right. We have to think of a way to finally get Emma. But, I mean, how do we even do that? If she's obeyed the cops this far, how are we supposed to catch her? I just don't think it's gonna be that easy.
This wasn't Emma.
What?
Zoe.
I'm sorry, Chris, but he has the right to know. We just watched our roommate get killed in front of us, and we have to figure out who did this and how we can get them. And we can use all the help we can get.
Okay, I'm so lost right now. You guys want to catch up to speed?
We don't think that the person who's killing everyone is Emma. We think that it may have been somebody who's after us for something that we did in high school.
Which was?
It was Halloween 3 years ago.
Hey guys, maybe we should head back to class.
No, Zoe, we'll be fine. So what are we doing tonight?
I don't know yet. I think maybe we should go to Sean's Halloween party.
Sean the water polo player?
Yes, the water polo player.
He's so hot.
Hey, don't get any ideas. If we're going tonight, I call dibs on him first.
Why do you always get to call dibs on everything, Lauren?
Because I'm a senior, and you two are just sophomores, which means I get priority in everything. And besides, what? He gave me the invite. You guys are just my plus two.
Whatever you say, Lauren.
Oh my God. Is that Grace Crawford?
Yeah. So?
Who on earth dresses up like that for Halloween when they're in high school? This is too good. Come on, girls.
Lauren, don't. She's special.
Nice costume. Did your mommy make it for you?
No. I got it at a discount mart.
For fuck's sake, spit it out. You sound like a broken record.
don't say that. It's mean.
I don't fucking care. Newsflash, Grace. No one dresses up for Halloween anymore unless they're dressing up in something slutty, which I would definitely avoid if I were you, because no one wants to fuck a retard.
Lauren,
this chick is gonna die a virgin.
Anything you want to say, Zoe?
Look, Grace, maybe you should take off the costume. Be best for everyone, especially you.
But I like my costume.
I don't see why you felt the need to dress up anyway. You're already abnormally freakish as it is.
You know, one of these days you're really going to regret making fun of me.
I highly doubt that. Happy Halloween, bitch.
Zoe?
Jesus, that's so fucked up. But in all honesty, I doubt someone started killing people 3 years later because of it.
Yeah, well, it's not the end of the story.
You guys made her kill herself?
Yeah, we did. And we think that our past is finally coming back to haunt us.
Oh my God.
you're not mad at me, right? For, you know, not telling you sooner?
Don't worry about that. We have bigger issues to deal with right now.
Hey, where are we going?
Well, if we want to find out who this killer is and finally catch them, we have to go to the person who can help us the most. Logan! Yo, Logan, you here? It's weird, he's usually up by now. Oh, hey, Austin. Have you seen Logan around here?
I know. I haven't seen him all day.
What's up with the double bag?
I'm headed home for a day or two.
Oh, cool. Catch you later, man.
Alright, later. See you soon.
See you, man. Pretty quiet guy, tends to keep to himself. Reminds me of that Stavo guy from season 2 of Scream. Even likes to draw weird little pictures like him too.
Oh, that's what this is? That's creepy as fuck.
Yeah, I thought so too at first, but the guy's harmless. That has to be Logan. Probably forgot his key. Follow the trails and clues you'll find, but you must hurry if you want to see Logan alive. God, why on earth would the killer kidnap Logan?
Because they're just fucking with us. Why does A do any of the things they do on PLL? This is all just one big game to them.
We can't compare this to Pretty Little Liars. A doesn't just go around massacring half the student body.
Where do we even know where to look for him? This campus is huge, and besides, we could have taken him somewhere outside of campus. Hello?
You guys look so lost right now. It looks like you need all the help you can get.
Screw you. If you hurt Logan or do anything to him, I swear I'm gonna...
Oh, relax. You'll get your little friend back as long as you follow my instructions.
Let me guess, no cops.
You can go to the cops all you want. It's not like they've been much help so far.
Where the hell is Logan?
You want to find out where your friend Logan is? Go to the place where this massacre first began.
Tell me where Logan is.
Don't be so upset. I could have kidnapped your girlfriend if I wanted to. Or aren't you glad I did it?
I swear, if I find out who this is, I'm gonna...
You're gonna what? Kill me? See, now that's my job. And you had better hurry before I make Logan my next victim.
Damn it!
What did they say?
Said if we want to find where Logan is, we have to go back to the place where the massacre first started.
Well, then we're here. The entire killing spree started at the university. That sure as hell didn't help.
Wait, no, it didn't.
Yeah, it did, Zoe.
No, think about it. If we're right about this, and the killer is someone other than Emma, then the killing spree all started with Lauren's death. I think the killer wants us to go back to Lauren's house.
Let's go. I'll drive. Is this the place?
Yeah, it is.
Wow, this is not what I was expecting.
Why is that?
Just from what you guys said about Lauren, expecting a huge mansion with a gold fountain out front.
Yeah, well, not only was she manipulative, but she was also kind of a poser.
That, and the mansion was out of the budget.
Gotcha. All right, let's do it. Thank you.
What do you want?
Miss Tipton, it's me and Kristen. We used to be Lauren's best friends, remember?
I know who you are. So what the hell do you want?
We were wondering if we could take a look around real quick.
Get the hell out of here! Take Abercrombie with you!
Wait. The reason we want to look around is because one of our friends is in trouble. And we're also hoping that it might help us find out who killed Lauren.
I know who killed my baby! It's that psycho nut Emma!
We may not be so sure.
Yeah, and if we can look around, we might have some clue as to who did.
Come in.
So, how are you holding up, Mrs. Tipton?
How do you think? My daughter escapes a massacre back at school, only to be murdered in the comfort of her own home? I had a bad feeling about that night. Call it mother's intuition, but when I talked to her on the phone, I had a feeling it was gonna be the last time.
Sorry to hear that.
Yeah. Lauren always thought she was invincible.
Miss Tipton, can you tell us anything about the days leading up to Lauren's death? I mean, was there anything strange or out of the ordinary?
Actually, there was. She received a letter about a week before she died.
What's so strange about that?
Well, what was so strange about it is there's no postage on it. It was just her name with big red letters, as if somebody put it in the mailbox themselves.
Did you report to the police?
No, I just thought it was one of the boys in the neighborhood writing her a love letter.
Where's the letter right now?
It's somewhere in her room.
Do you mind if we go take a look around?
Go ahead. If it helps you find who killed my baby, go for it.
Thanks.
I think this is it.
Who is it?
It's Grace.
I think there's something else. It's a picture of us at the Orange Grove.
Orange Grove? I think that's where the killer's holding Logan. Earlier on the phone, the killer said, "Orange, you glad I didn't take your little girlfriend, Zoe?" He must be holding with Orange Grove. How far is this place?
It's not far. It's like 20, 30 minutes with traffic.
Let's go.
Hello? Anybody home?
Emma, why haven't you contacted me in so long? That doesn't matter. You're more than just a serial killer. The cops have been looking for you for over a year. It's starting to look more suspicious now that more people are dying again. You have to tell me, Emma. Are you responsible for these murders too? No. Don't hang up. I wasn't accusing you. I was just... Damn it.
How big is this place?
Like an acre or two, I think.
We'll never find him. We're like looking for a needle in a haystack.
Hey, don't worry. We'll find him.
What the hell?
I just got a text message from a blocked number.
Yeah, me too.
Same. That's weird.
You found Logan. The game's just begun.
This is the part where it really gets fun.
Find Logan in 30 minutes or his life will be done.
A. Oh my god. That was so cool. The way that we all just said A like that simultaneously, like...
Focus! We have a half an hour to find Logan. I think splitting up would be our best bet.
Are you sure about that?
Yeah, it'll increase our chances of finding him. You guys look with each other and I'll go look by myself.
Okay.
Meet here in 20 minutes. Call me if you guys find anything.
Alright.
Okay.
Logan! Logan!
God, this is so pointless. He could be anywhere.
Which is exactly why we have to keep looking. What?
You really like this boy, don't you?
Why do you say that?
Because you're risking your life to save his roommate. And because you told him our secret.
So? You told Jason?
Yeah, because he was my boyfriend. Come on, Zoe. You totally want to bang this guy.
I do not. I just think that he's very handsome and caring.
Bullshit.
Okay, you're right. I do like him. Actually, a lot. But you are wrong about one thing.
What's that?
I do not want to bang him. Because I already did.
You slut! When did you do this?
It was when we were staying in his room the other night and, you know, I was in his bedroom. We got to talking and one thing led to another.
That's when you were gone for like 2 hours.
Yeah. You know, I wanted to tell you. It just never found the right time.
Stitches in that leg.
No. Just some hydrogen peroxide and tequila, I think.
Alright, let's get you help.
Grayson. Hey, Captain. No, I don't think I'll be coming back to the station tonight.
Campus PD's got me set up with an office here. Yeah. Well. Wait, there was another murder last night? Who's the victim? Yeah, I mean, I had some leads, but you know, they didn't pan out. Well, all I know is as of now, the case seems to somehow revolve around Zoe Cosgrove and Kristen Conrad, but I don't know, let's keep going.